वेलकम टू दिस वीडियो लेक्चर। माई सेल्फ अतुल कुमार, वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस, राजीव गांधी मेमोरियल, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, जोगिंद्रनगर। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल गिव यू मोर डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन अबाउट MS Word फीचर्स। सो फर्स्टली आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू क्रिएट ए मेल मर्ज इन MS Word प्रैक्टिकली। सो टू क्रिएट ए मेल मर्ज, फर्स्टली आई हैव टू राइट ए letter that I have to send to different peoples or recipient. So firstly I am just writing here a letter from, suppose the company name is RGM Government College Jogindranagar. So if you want to create a letter that is to be sent to different recipient, the first line is from where that letter is coming. So here I am writing here from RGM Government College Jogindranagar. You can use a company letterhead or any other thing in your letter. So in the letter we start with to, here we start with the recipient name, address, and the next is the subject. Subject here is, suppose, learning about मेल मर्ज। नेक्स्ट इज डियर सर और मैडम। नेक्स्ट हेयर यू हैव टू राइट ए लेटर। सो जस्ट आई एम पुटिंग हेयर सम रेंडम पैराग्राफ्स ऑफ फोर लाइन ईच एंड three paragraphs. So just I am giving a tab to start a paragraph, and this one is the end of the paragraph. After ending we close the letter with thank you, and next we have with thank you RGM company name Government College Jogindranagar. So this letter is all almost ready, and now we have to just put here the address of the recipient. So just click the mailing tab, and here we have to select the recipient. When we use this option or click this option, select recipient, so there are different options. The first option is type a new list, other option is use an existing document, and if you have already a list of recipient then use this option, or if you have a database of existing recipient then you can choose this option, or you can also choose the contacts from your Outlook Express. So just I don't have any list, so I have to just type a new list here. So when I click a type a new list, a new address list dialog box appears, and here you can see different kinds of fields are already available. We have title, we have first name, last name, so many fields are there, address line, city, state, zip code. You can just customize these columns. To customize the columns or fields in new address list, just click on this customize column, and here you can add the column in the list, or you can also delete the column. Suppose I don't want this title in my address list, so just click here delete and click on OK. So title is not now available on or your list. Next, if you want to take first name, if you want to take the last name, just delete this last name. Yes, then company name, I want this. Address line 1, I want this. I don't want address line 2, just delete this option. Next is city, I want this. State also I want, and country of or region I don't want, so just delete this. Also I don't want home phone number, so also delete this. Work phone, delete this. And email, I also don't want this option or field in my list. Also zip code I don't want, state. So just I want these 5 fields in my address list of recipient, that is first name, company name, address line 1, city and state. Then click on OK. Now you can just add the recipient information here. Suppose the first name is Nikhil, company is suppose XYZ, address line is suppose Nehru Place, and city is Delhi, and state is also Delhi, New Delhi. If you want to add a new entry, then click on this new entry, Akhil. My company name is FGE, and Ambala Road, city is Ambala, and state here is Haryana. Next entry is Santosh, company is KRT, and here Chandigarh, sector 43, city suppose Chandigarh, and state is also Chandigarh. So these are the recipient for to whom I want to send this letter. So the first, if I want to send a letter to these 3 recipient, the first option we have, just write different these 3 letters individually by typing the address of these recipient and typing the letter and send them individually. The other method is just create one letter and just use the option of mail merge, and you can send this letter to these recipient. So now that my list is ready, just click on OK, and it will ask you to where you want to save this list. So I want to save this in desktop, and my recipient is the name of the list, suppose, and save. Now your list is saved. The next thing you can now use, select recipient and use an existing list. So in use an existing list, if you have already a existing list, suppose I just created a list of my recipient, So this one is my recipient list, and the extension of this file is .mdv. This means this is a Excel file. My Excel file, just open this, and now you can use this list in your document. So to just use the field, just click on insert merge field, sorry, I think list is not selected here, so just use an existing list and desktop my recipient, click on open and now you can see here in my list there are five fields I have just added: first name, company name, address line 1, and city and state. Suppose I want first name here after 2, so this field is added. Second thing I want here as a company name, so here company name is added. Now the third thing is, or the third field I want to insert here is address line 1. Then I want to insert here city and then state. Also, if you want to add a greeting line, there is an option of greeting line like dear sir, madam. It is already ready-made available in this mailing tab. So here greeting line, when you click this greeting line option, insert greeting line dialog box appears, and here the first you can just use greeting line format. Here we have different greeting line format like dear to, so we can use this dear as an option. So you can use Mr. There are different kinds of options available by what title or by what sense you want this. So suppose I will use this option. So the greeting line for invalid recipient, if there are no valid recipient, then it will just use this option, dear sir or madam. So here is the preview from your recipient list. So my first recipient is Nikhil, so it will just display dear Nikhil in your letter like this. So just click OK, and here greeting line is added in our letter. So the next, now my letter is already completed in all sense. Now I want to watch the preview, or I want to preview the results. So there is an option of preview results, just click here, and here you can see the first name is Nikhil, then we have a company name, we have a city and state. So these this one is the first letter. If you want to see the next recipient letter, so this one is second recipient. There is a forward or left previous record. If you want to go to the next record, just click on this. So there we have only 3 records. In this way you can create a letter and send it to different persons or recipient that are that you can give with the help of this select recipients. And the last step is to finish the mail merge. Just click on this. There are three options available. First is edit individual, the second is print document, and the third option is send email. You can just send an email. If you want to print the document, just click on this print document, and it will ask print records all, current record, or if you want to print only second and third record, then there is also option of printing individual or from to. Option is also available. Suppose I want to print all the record, just click on OK, and it will ask, just I want to print it as a PDF format, and just I click on OK, and now it will start printing, and it will ask where to save your PDF file. So suppose my file name is mail merge letter, and I want to save this in desktop. Just click on save. Now your file is saved in your desktop as mail merge, and here you can see this one is the first letter, this one is the second letter to Akhil, third letter is to Santosh. So in this way you can use this mail merge option in MS Word to just send a letter or any kind of envelope or labels to different kind of recipient. So thanks for watching this video lecture.